So hi, Microbehunter here. Well, today I want to talk a little bit about stability issues when you connect a DSLR camera to a microscope, like I have done here. Sometimes people do not have a phototube. Normally you would connect the camera, of course, to the trinocular tube, to the phototube. Some microscopes don't have it, and it's still possible to connect a DSLR camera over the eyepiece. However, there might be a few challenges, especially if your microscope is not very large. And one of those challenges is that your microscope actually might tip over if the camera and the adapter, if they are too heavy. So in this case, I recommend that you use a microphone stand. So this is actually a microphone stand. And I now kind of changed it around up here in such a way that I'm able to connect now also a camera. And in order to do this, you need a so-called a ball head, which on one side is able to connect to the microphone stand, and on the other side it has a camera connection. I'm going to show you later how this looks like. That is one thing, and this microphone stand is actually can be changed in length, so it's extensible. In this particular case, even the microphone stand that I had was not even long enough, so I had to add a second tube here. Okay, so actually I connected two microphone stands here to make it long enough. I'm just showing this to you that this is a possibility, especially if you take a lot of videos and so on. Then you can of course also use the screen here then to directly look at the things that you're looking at, and this gives a lot of stability, especially when you want to do, for example, time lapse or so on. Then you want to have the stability, because otherwise if you don't have this, then the camera can turn around quite easily, and then you're kind of losing a little bit the composition that you set up. Okay, sometimes you might want to turn the camera anyway because you want to reframe everything, but sometimes not. So in this case, I recommend that you use some kind of a stand here. Some people can also want to use a small tripod. This is also possible. Tripods, however, do require a little bit more space. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to show you my setup, and then you can do with the information whatever you want. Maybe it's useful for you, maybe there are also other alternatives that are a little bit easier and less bulky than this one here. So let's get started. So this here is my DSLR connected to the eyepiece of my stereo microscope. Simply to show you how I'm using the microphone stand. There is a ball head at the top, and the length of the microphone stand can be changed. There is a little grip here that can be turned, and this tightens and loosens the stand, and therefore you can extend it. And that's important because when you focus the stereo microscope, of course the whole system has to go up and down, and therefore it's important that this be extensible. Without the stand, the microscope is stable enough, but the camera itself likes to turn very easily. Not a big problem, I would say, but there is more stability, it would be nice. Okay, in order to connect the camera, you need an adapter ring, because the camera has a 23 millimeter adapter, and a 3 millimeter tube, and the microscope a 30 millimeter, because 30 millimeters is standard for stereo microscopes, and therefore you need this adapter ring. And I'm taking off now the adapter here. There is another adapter called the T2 adapter ring here, and this one is camera specific, the T2. So you have to make sure that you get a proper T2 adapter ring to be able to connect it to your camera. And that here is the optics of the small camera adapter. So that is basically, there are several things that you have to make sure that they fit together. This here is the ball head, and on the bottom here I've got a 3/8 inch threading, and this 3/8 inch is for microphones. Okay, and therefore I'm able to fit it to the microphone stand. And on the top, that's a camera connector. It's a 1/4 inch. So you need to have a ball head that is able to, has two different types of threadings. Here I'm just showing you the extensibility of the microphone stand and how it can be tightened again. And there's another ring here on top to make sure that the ball head is also tight. You can of course use this to connect mobile phone cameras like I've been using here, but here I'm just showing you that I have a second stand here which is a little bit smaller, which cannot be extended, but it is possible to take off the stand here. And on the bottom you also have a 3/8 of an inch, so this means that I'm able to actually extend the microphone stand yet again by adding another one of these stands here. That's actually what I've done. I've connected two of them together. Here, right now I'm connecting it directly to the eyepiece of my compound microscope. It's also stable enough, but it likes to turn. But then again, I've got a pretty heavy microscope. Yeah, I ordered those ball heads, two times the same one, but I got two different things. You got to be careful here a little bit. The left one here has a 1/4 of an inch, and the right one has a 3/8 of an inch connector. So this means that at the top I've always got a 1/4 of an inch, of course, but on the bottom I was not always able to mount it to a microphone stand. And so I was because only the right one I was able to mount and the left one not, even though it's the same thing, but they sent me two different products. So if you have this problem, you can buy again yet another adapter ring here, where you can put it in, and then I again have a 3/8 of an inch of the threading here where I can connect yet again to the microphone stand. So you see, you got to play around a little bit with all of those adapters, but you got to just be careful that you get the ones with the right size here, otherwise you're not able to mount this. Yeah, and here we see how I'm mounting the ball head to the microphone stand. Yeah, and here we go, ready to connect the camera. So that's it, people. Wish you all the best. Happy microbe hunting as always, and see you around next time. Bye bye.